Hello from Gama. I am Lakshman Maheshwary and today we are going to talk about the Paika Bidroha of 1817. The Paika Bidroha or the Paika Rebellion predates what has been popularly regarded as the First War of Independence in 1857. This was an armed rebellion against the British East India Company's rule in Odisha in 1817 under Bakshi Jagat Bandhu. It projected Lord Jagannath as a symbol of Odia unity and it quickly spread across most of the Odisha. So let us talk about the Paikas. They were the landed peasant militias of the Gajapati rulers of Odisha. They rendered military services to the king during the times of wars and took up policing and cultivation during times of peace. Let us go to the genesis of the rise of discontent in Odisha. It all started with the conquest of Odisha by the East India Company in 1803. They dethroned the Raja of Khurda. The rulers of Khurda were the custodian of the Jagannath temple and ruled as the deputy of Jagannath on earth. They symbolized the political and cultural freedom of the people of Odisha. Further, with the fall of the Raja of Khurda, there was a fall in the power and prestige of the Paikas. British treated Paikas as a threat. They took over their hereditary, rent-free lands and subjected Paikas to extortion and oppression. As early as in 1804, the Raja of Khurda planned a rebellion against the British in alliance with the Paikas. However, the plot was discovered and the Raja's territory were confiscated. Perhaps the most important leader of the Paika revolution was Bakshi Jagat Bandhu Bidyadhar Mahapatra Brahmabhar Ray. He was a former Bakshi or commander of the forces of the Raja of Khurda. His familiar estate of Killa Rohrang was taken over by the British in 1814. The Paikas were organized under his leadership. The revolution began in March 1817, when a 400 strong party of the tribals of Ghumsar entered into Khurda, openly declaring their rebellion against the company's rule. The Paikas under Jagat Bandhu joined them. They attacked British symbols of power, setting ablaze police stations, administrative offices, and the treasury during their march towards Khurda, from where the British fled. The revolt quickly gained momentum. It was supported by the Rajas of Kanika, Kujang, Nayaghar and Ghumsar. Raja Mukund Dev, the last king of Khurda, was another important leader. Dalabera Mir Haider Ali of Jadupur was an important Muslim rebel. Zamindars, village heads and ordinary peasants participated. The revolt moved to Puri, Pipli, Katak and other parts of the province. The British faced stiff resistance from the rebelling Paikas. However, sadly, by May 1817, the British managed to re-establish their authority over the entire province. Widespread suppression followed. Many were killed, imprisoned and tortured. Some rebels fought a guerrilla war till 1819. But were eventually captured and killed. Jagat Bandhu was finally arrested in 1825 and died in captivity in 1829. Even though the Paika revolt ended, Odisha continued her freedom struggle. There was Tapanga rebellion in 1827 and Banapur rebellion of 1835. Although the Paika Bidroha enjoys a cult status in Odisha, with children growing up with stories of the brave fight against the British, it received rather less attention at the national level than it should have got. However, the Government of India has decided to give the event its due recognition and is commemorating its 200th anniversary in a befitting manner. In this picture, you can see Prime Minister Narendra Modi felicitating Upasana, a descendant of Paika rebellion leader Bakshi Jagat Bandhu, in Bhuvaneshwar. This was the video about Paika Bidroha. I am Lakshman Maheshwari. This video was brought to you by Gamma IAS classes. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and share to keep receiving important updates. Have a good day.